Hello students, in this video we will study the classification of phylum Platyhelminthes. So in last video we already studied the characters of phylum Platyhelminthes. So here now we study the classification of phylum Platyhelminthes. See this class Platyhelminthes, phylum Platyhelminthes is divided into the three main classes. Okay, so phylum Platyhelminthes is divided into three classes. First one is known as Turbellaria. Second one is known as Trematoda. And the third one is known as Cystoda. So here, if you just study the first one, that is the Turbellaria. Okay, we comparatively study all these three classes. So these animals from the Turbellaria, they are free living, and particularly they are either present in fresh water or they are present in the marine water. Some of them, if they are aquatic, they are present in the fresh water or marine water. Some of them, they are also present in the soil, while some they shows the commensal, or some of them they are parasitic in habitat. Okay, so they are either free living or they act as a commensals, or they are parasitic one. When they are free living, they are present either in the soil or in the fresh or in the water. And in case of aquatic habitat, either it is fresh water or marine water. Then second thing is that the body of those animal is the dorso-ventrally flattened body. Dorso-ventrally flattened body is there. The body is bilaterally symmetrical as well as it is unsegmented. Means the body is not divided into segments. So without segmentation, the body is dorsoventrally flattened and it is bilaterally symmetrical. Patti aste na apli ta patti sarkhi chappat aste. Dorsal ani ventral doni side ne. So the dorsoventrally flattened body is there and it is bilaterally symmetrical. If we draw a line, we get the two parts and both are equal. So that is known as a bilateral symmetry. Then the anterior end of the body, which is differentiated into the head, means we can easily observe the head. Body is covered by single layer of epidermis. And that epidermis is either cellular or the epidermal layer is syncytial, and it may be partly or wholly ciliated. Rod-like curve rhabdoids are also present. Then the adhesive organs, means organs which are helpful for remain attached to the substratum. Okay, so the adhesive organs, which are modified one, and they are called as glandulo-epidermal adhesive organ. Okay, glandulo-epidermal adhesive organ. Or second type, that is known as glandulomuscular adhesive organ. म्हणजे जे काही ग्लँड्स असतील त्या ग्लँड्सच्या ते एपिडर्मल लेअरला किंवा ग्लँड्सच्या मसल्सला हे ऑर्गन अडेजनसाठी किंवा चिकटून राहण्यासाठी मदत करतात. ओके, द माउथ. माउथ विच इज व्हेंट्रल इन अ पोझिशन. The pharynx is protrusible, means the pharynx, okay, is protrusible. So the pharynx, which is protrusible, Then the next intestine is present and it shows the variation. Intestine is with variation. Then the next one, the excretory organs are there. Organs which are present in the form of protonephridia. So the protonephridias are present, which are act as excretory organ. Most of the animal, they are hermaphrodite, means the male and female, they are present in a single individual, and due to that we called it as a hermaphrodite. Then the crossed fertilization is there. Though both the individuals are present, reproductive systems are present in the same individual, but the process of cross fertilization takes place. Self fertilization is avoided. Then reproduction takes place by both the way, asexual method and sexual method, and they also possesses the power of regeneration. So few of them, they are produced by the process of regeneration. For example, planaria, bipennium. So these are the different examples. So this is about the terbellaria. So this is the first example. We also call it as a digesia, convoluta. This is the bipallium. So these are the example from the terbellaria. Second class, which is trematoda. The individuals, they are not the free living. They are either act as ectoparasite or they are act as endoparasites. And since we commonly call them as the flukes, so liver fluke is the example of this trematoda. Then the body, which is maybe leaf-like or which is oval or it is elongated. The animals, they lack the epidermis, because epidermis is act as the outermost protective covering, and as it is the outermost protective covering, but the animals are act as an endoparasite. So in that case, the animals, they lack the epidermis. And though there is absence of epidermis, the thick cuticle is present. Then different types of the suckers are act as adhesive organs. They are act as organs to remain attached. Mouth, which is present towards the anterior end, and the digestive system, which possesses mouth, then pharynx, esophagus, then the intestine. And the intestine is large and bifid. Then the protonephridias are present, and these protonephridia, they are act as the organ of excretion. They are helpful for process of excretion. Nervous system is there, which is consist of the paired cerebral ganglion, which is similar to that of the brain in case of the higher animals. So here the paired cerebral ganglia is present, and the longitudinal cords are also present. So the nervous system, which is made up of the paired cerebral ganglion and the longitudinal cord. The animals, they are hermaphrodite animal. We know what is hermaphrodite animal, with a few exceptions. Remaining all other are the hermaphrodite animal. The adults, they lack the sense organs, as they are act as the endoparasite. There is no need of sense organs. and since the adult they lack the sense organ. The life cycle, which may be simple, means it requires only a single host to complete. Sometimes the life cycle may be complex or complicated, as it required more than two hosts to complete. And it also possesses the larval stages, which are present in the different hosts. So all these are the characters of the second class, that is the Trematoda. And the example is liver fluke. Okay, so this is the first example, liver fluke, and this is the second example, cystostoma. Both they are with the flat body and they are act as the endoparasite. Okay, up to here we completed the Turbellaria, which is the first class from the phylum Platyhelminthes. Second class is the Trematoda and third one is the Cystoda. Now we study the characters of class Cystoda from phylum Platyhelminthes. See, these animals from the Cystoda, they are commonly known as tapeworms. They are endoparasites. Means the animals, they are specifically endoparasites. The animals, they lack epidermis, which is act as the outermost protective covering. They also lack rhabdoids as well as the cilia, which are present externally. Then the body, which is divided into segments, and the segments are known as proglottids. And due to the presence of the segments, means proglottids, we can say that the body of the animal is divisible into three parts. The first one, scolex, second one, neck, and third one, that is the strobila. So scolex, neck, and strobila, they are the three body parts. Scolex, it is also known as head. It is with suckers. Suckers are helpful to remain attached. If the suckers are absent, hooks are present. Means the scolex, they possesses either suckers or they possesses the hooks. And both these organs are helpful to remain attached to the surface, because these Cystoda, animals from Cystoda, they are endoparasitic one. Then mouth and alimentary canal are totally absent. Okay. Then three types of the proglottids are there. As we know that the body is divisible into segments. These proglottids are of three type. The first type, which is known as immature proglottid, second one, that is known as the mature, and the third one, that is known as the gravid proglottids. So such a three types of the proglottids are there. The gravid proglottids, last one, they just detach or they just shed off by the process of apolysis, and they get detached from the original body. Then the sense organs, they are absent. Mostly these animals are hermaphrodite, though we call them as a hermaphrodite, male and a female reproductive system present in the single individual. They shows the process of self-fertilization. And life cycle is completed either in a single host or more than two hosts are required to complete the life cycle. And the example of this cystoda, that is the tapeworm. And the second example, that is the dog tapeworm, which is also known as the Echinococcus granulosus. See, this is the Echinococcus granulosus, which is the first example, and the Tinea solium, which is the tapeworm. So you are able to observe here the scolex, neck, and the remaining other body parts. We already studied that the body of the animal, which is divided into the scolex, neck, and strobila. So the strobila, which is divided into the immature pleurotes, which are present near to the neck region. These immature ones, they become matured proglottids. Slowly and slowly the size increases. And towards the posterior end, the matured proglottids, they get converted into the gravid proglottids, which is get detached from the body by the process of the apolysis. Okay, so this is about the two examples, tapeworm and the Echinococcus granulosus. Okay, so here we study the three different type of the classes of phylum Platyhelminthes with their example. Thank you.